feeling powerless and powerlessness. This feeling and emotion is one of the most important emotions in human existence, or learning about this emotion, in my personal opinion, is the most important in our human experience. The difference between how you react in a situation when you are in an empowered state and when you are in this empowered state is like a day and night. You can be in exactly the same situation, dealing with exactly the same people. But when you are doing this in empowered attitude versus disempowered, the whole effect and the whole feelings and the consequences and the reaction that you get are completely different. Disempowerment feels like you are trapped and have no choice and you have no options in a situation. When you feel disempowered by the person as well, very often, you feel like that person is taking away your power. And you feel like you have no control over that. So, the funny or the tricky thing is, though, that this is not completely true. This is actually true from the feeling perspective. It feels like that person is taking your power away completely. It feels like that situation is taking your power completely. And the feeling of that is absolutely real. There is no question about it. However, from the higher scheme of things, from the higher point of view, we always have choice and we always have power. We have power, even if you don't have any kind of like a physical or influential power, or at least we perceive ourselves that we don't have that. We have a power of choice on our perspective. How we're going to choose to see the situation. Now, I actually simplified this because in reality, or let's say in practicality, I could say probably 82-86% of the time, and this number is completely intuitive, we are reactive. We are not empowered in our choices. And sometimes we reacting in a habitual way. We get involved in this pattern of one person doing something and us reacting that way. That person is doing something and we're reacting that way. Or we react that way and that person is doing something further and it's kind of like a vicious circle. Once I seen this very good post on Facebook, I think, and it was like a row of matches. You know, matches that make light. The wooden matches. And there was a quote. One match was kind of moved away a little bit lower from the line, and there was a sentence saying, you have a power basically to step away. By stepping away, you break the chain. That's probably not exact quotation, but the idea was that there is a sequence and chain of events, and those events, basically one event gets in motion another event, gets in motion another event, and so on and so on and so on. And how do you break the chain? You step out of that. Sometimes it's very hard thing to do. However, it is possible to do it. It might require some work on self-empowerment, changing concept about yourself. There may be some work needed to integrate some trauma that you have experienced, probably in your childhood. Well, definitely your childhood, but most of the people, or lots of people, we don't really remember absolutely everything that happened in our childhood. So sometimes that integration is required for you to start stepping into the space where you can feel, start to feel empowered and start having real choices. Empowerment and disempowerment in one sentence, I could say like this. Disempowerment is not being able to connect with your personal power. Empowerment is when you are able to connect with your personal power. By personal power, I mean it could be like a power of your heart, power of your solar plexus, power of your personality, power of your soul, power of your spirit. So whichever way you like to call it, nonetheless, is the power which is not dependent from what you wear, how you look, what's your race, what's your skin color, what's your occupation, how much you earn, and where you live. Not saying that these things don't affect our sense of empowerment or disempowerment. However, what I mean is your sense of inner power, your empowerment, is actually non-dependent on any of those circumstances in your physical life. Let me know what have you experienced in terms of disempowering and empowering in your life. Let me know if you have any questions, and let me know if you have found any methods, tools, or techniques that works best for your empowerment. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.